జై శ్రీమన్నారాయణ. ఇన్ ఓల్డెన్ డేస్ హిందూస్ వర్ గోయింగ్ టు కాశీ అండ్ ముస్లిమ్స్ టు హాస్ యాజ్ పిల్గ్రిమేజ్ ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీటింగ్ దేర్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీస్. సిన్స్ దెర్ వర్ నో ఫెసిలిటీస్ అండ్ దే హ్యాడ్ టు గో ఆన్ ఫోట్, దే వర్ డౌట్ఫుల్ వెదర్ దే వుడ్ కమ్ బ్యాక్ సేఫ్లీ. వన్స్ ఎన్ ఓల్డ్ ఉమెన్ డిసైడెడ్ టు గో టు హాస్. షీ హ్యాడ్ సేవ్డ్ సమ్ గోల్డ్ కాయిన్స్ ఫర్ హర్ ఫ్యూచర్. షీ వాజ్ లుకింగ్ ఫర్ ఎన్ ఆనెస్ట్ మ్యాన్ at whom her coins could be protected. She found such a man and said, I am planning to go to Haas. We'll come back in 10 months. I have saved some gold coins. I am living in a poor hut, so I can't save there. Someone may rob them. Can you please save my money in your house? You save for 10 months. If I don't come back, you can use them. But if I come back, please hand it over to me. In old days, I can't work anywhere. So these coins will help me in future. The man agreed. She handed over a pouch made of cloth containing gold coins. The opening of the pouch was stitched very carefully. She left for pilgrimage. The man waited for 6 months. He needed money. The pouch given by the lady came to his mind. He said to himself, "It is very difficult to an old lady who made such a long journey on foot to survive. Perhaps she might have died. Anyway, she told me to use that money if she doesn't come. No doubt, she might have died." Thinking so, he spent those coins. But the lady, as said, reached after 10 months. He went to him and asked for her coins. Without saying a word, he handed over the pouch. She was very happy. "You are very honest. You gave my pouch. Allah will take care of you and your family." Thus blessed him and went home. When she opened the pouch, in place of coins, she found some stones. "He handed over the pouch to me the way I gave him. But what happened to my coins?" She was worried and went to him and said the same. The man said, "See, my dear old lady, I returned your pouch the same way you gave me. See, it was stitched. How do I know what was kept inside? Please don't blame me." She came back in tears. She went to the King Akbar and complained. Akbar had a clever minister named Birbal. He called his minister and told him to solve the problem. He asked his subjects to get some pouches of the same size and of the same color. He made holes to each one, dropped some stones in it. All professional tailors were called and asked each one to stitch the hole, what we call as darning, such a way that it should not be identified as if it was stitched. All tailors did what Birbal said. He called the old lady to bring her pouch. He compared all pouches with that of the lady. There was only one pouch stitched in the same way, so perfectly and skillfully. Birbal assembled all three, the tailor who stitched it, the man who kept old lady's pouch in his house, and the old lady. All were made to assemble at one place. Birbal asked the tailor showing old lady's pouch, "Did you stitch the hole in old woman's pouch?" He observed it and said, "Yes, Jahwapana, the white and black pouch once I stitched, but this lady did not give me, but that man," said the tailor, pointing the man. He further continued, "He put some stones in it and asked me to stitch the hole. For that he gave a gold coin. It is still there with me." Birbal asked him to get that coin. The tailor went to bring it. Meanwhile, Birbal asked the lady, "How do we know those coins are yours?" The lady said, "Before giving the coins, I made red mark on each coin, Jahwapana." The tailor came back with the coin. The coin too had a red mark on it. Then Akbar came to know how the man cheated the old Muslim lady and punished him and warned the lady not to trust anyone in that way. He gave her some gold coins and sent her back. This story reveals that a person may be honest, but circumstances may change an honest person into a dishonest person. Anyway, we have to be very careful. Thanks to Rama Garu and Suman TV for providing thought-provoking stories for the kids.